Jesse Eisenberg, welcome back to the program. You look sharp, and I...
Likewise, thank you.
I'm happy that you're here. Thank you for coming back.
Thank you.
Well, we have a lot to talk about. I want to talk about a Sasquatch sunset.
Yes.
It's very fun and very interesting, different. I've never seen anything quite like it.
Nor will you ever again.
Yeah, all right, thank you.
No, it's the most unusual thing I've ever gotten to do, and it's absolutely brilliant, charming, funny, emotional, but we are all playing Sasquatches. There's four characters in the movie, and we are head-to-toe fully Sasquatch.
Yeah, but before I get into that, sure. I want to ask you about... I want to ask a lot of your fans out there of the Now You See Me films.
Oh, yeah.
There were two giant blockbusters, and now there's talk that there's a third that's going to be made.
Yes, you know,
it's happening.
It's happening. You know, the world has been asking for it, and, you know, we said yes.
Yeah. How exciting is it? When
is
that you started shooting already?
We start like in 2 months. Oh, but it's just wonderful. It's like the, you know, most incredible group of people. The movies are so much fun, and it gives the public the illusion that I have some amazing skill set with magic.
And do you have any magical skills?
No, nothing. I have like a deficit. You can ask any random person in the world, there'd be a better magician than me. I just, you know, I don't have coordination or cleverness or ability to lie to people. Yeah.
You don't have, this is just straight acting in this film.
It's pure amazing acting.
But when you walk down the street, people go, you're a great magician.
Yes, yes, can you please, here, it's my child's birthday, do something to entertain them.
Yeah, I know.
And I tell a little, you know, snide joke, which is what I'm known for, and I move on and they are traumatized.
All right, so we can look forward to number three. Now let's get back and talk about Sasquatch. Sasquatch Sunset, you're all head to toe dresses Sasquatch.
That's right. Yes. Yeah.
And how did you hear about this idea? How did you? Who invented this idea? Who's
the inventors of the idea are probably long gone. The inventors of the Sasquatch.
But I meant
a movie.
Yes. Thank you. Yes, I meant that.
They're alive.
Yes. Yeah, good.
Yeah. I know them.
Oh.
Yeah.
How do you know them?
We met on the Sasquatch film. And
oh yeah, I heard about it.
So yeah, no, my friends, you know, actually I'm friends with the directors. They told me, you know, we have this movie we want to send you to act in. I said, thanks, I love everything you write, please. And they said, just before you read it, just know you'd be in full Sasquatch costume and you have no dialogue. And, you know, I said, oh, wonderful, I can't wait to read this thing I'll never act in, you know, because...
Yeah.
Of course, you know.
Actors don't want to be in something that you can't be seen or heard.
No, we need to be seen at all times. I want every moment of my life documented. So, so they sent me this thing, and it's just the most brilliant, funny thing. And after, like, two pages, I just thought, this is a wonderful character.
So what is the film about, though?
So it's about these four Sasquatches over the course of a year, kind of, you know, trying to survive in the wilderness. And it's so hard to describe because there's really nothing like it.
Yeah.
But in like 5 minutes, after like watching it for 5 minutes, you realize you're kind of just watching this movie about a family.
Yeah. I want to show you as a Sasquatch.
Thank you.
And here's you.
Yes.
I mean, you're really kind of charming.
I am, so basically, thank you very much.
They loved it already.
That's amazing.
Sasquatch Sunset, they're loving it already,
and
yes.
So the movie is like this, but it's moving all the time. And, I play kind of like, so people think of Sasquatches, of course, as like, you know, these kind of hulking, maybe aggressive creatures, you know.
Yeah.
But I play kind of like the poet. So my character is like kind of this thoughtful Sasquatch. Here I am with a butterfly. Oh. And, you know, only poets like butterflies. And so, so it really shows like kind of the other side of this mythical creature.
Yeah, and how did it feel to see yourself acting?
It was okay. I mean, the truth is, I like avoid watching myself in anything. In fact, I haven't like seen myself in a movie in like 15 years because I just get self-conscious, you know, and hearing the sound of my voice and all that stuff. So
this is a relief for you. You get to go.
I thought it would be a relief, you know. I thought, okay, this is great. I'm going to be fully in costume. I don't talk. I just grunt. And of course, I saw the movie for the first time, and I was like, oh God, that's how I grunt, you know. Oh, you know, it's like hearing your grunt on an answering machine.
There you go. Oh, God, I could have grunted better. This is awful.
I know. I was looking at all my gripes about my physical body were also imposed upon the Sasquatch. My posture is bad. Even for the missing link, my posture is bad.
You know, Your posture is actually fantastic.
Thank you. I've been working on it in anticipation for tonight.
No, I meant in the movie.
Thanks.
In general, your posture is good. But you went to like a boot camp, right?
Yes, we did like a Sasquatch boot camp.
I can't believe that exists.
It doesn't.
And okay.
it was like, it was a bespoke boot camp. It's not like we all signed up for the, you know, the Davos. So basically, you know, so we just created this like boot camp where we all learned how to kind of walk, how to grunt, how to, you know, call for other Sasquatches. We had like a vocabulary. We learned how to ask another Sasquatch, would you like to mate with me? So we really covered everything.
How do you do that? How does you come up with that?
If you want to mate with another Sasquatch, the polite way to do it is to just walk up to that, you know, Sasquatch and go like this, like. Yeah. It doesn't work with people, but
no.
It works with Sasquatches.
Yeah. But that's how you do it.
Yeah, and my character's so sweet, so I was kind of timid to ask the female to mate with me. I brought her a bouquet of ferns, and then I do this, and she says no. And then as I, like, scurry back scared, I do it again, and it just reminded me of basically every time I've ever spoken to a woman.
How are the costumes, by the way? How is the all? Because there's a lot of prosthetics and makeup, and it's amazing
job. It's excruciating. It's like 2 hours. I mean, you're basically wearing this like art project. So it's like 2 hours every morning of glue on every inch of your face, then yak hair. It's this claustrophobic experience, and
just for the face is 2 hours.
Yes.
Yeah,
wow. Just the face.
And then what's the bodysuit? What is that?
That's why I didn't mention it, because it was shorter, because it's less impressive. It was like 20 minutes to get the whole suit on. The face,
oh,
Jimmy.
The face. Sorry, the face. Yeah, yeah.
But can you believe
I would see, though, but after watching it, I go, well, that must be uncomfortable to act in.
It was. It was excruciating. But also, you know, we'd look in the mirror and you just think, like, I'm wearing this gorgeous art project. It's worth it. It feels like so amazing.
Is it hot in the suit?
It's hot. But luckily, we were filming like in the Redwoods and it was like in winter.
Where did you film, by the way? It's gorgeous.
In the Redwoods. Yeah, it's the most beautiful place in America. It's the Redwoods.
Stunning.
Yeah, it's Northern California. This is the place where, you know, Sasquatches are thought to be. And this is where, you know, this is where the Redwoods exist, and there's no other place like it in the world.
Can I ask, and we don't have to air this, did you run into any Sasquatches?
Yeah, no, I'm happy to say we ran into, like, so many real Sasquatches.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. They came out for the film.
It's just so weird. Like, every time they were there, we decided not to, like, film them.
That's so smart.
Yeah.
Out of respect.
Out of respect, and we just want to kind of keep the mystery alive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there was a few Sasquatches came to the premiere dressed as humans, and they were not discovered.
No. And they were tall, though, and we made sure they were sitting in the back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you believe in them more?
I love the mythology of the Sasquatch, you know, but I'm a skeptical person because I'm, you know, unhappy. And so, you know, so anything that's aspirational or hopeful or wouldn't that be great, I don't like that stuff.
So, in general, yeah.
Yeah, just, yeah.
Just,
of course,
you know, so
decades
smart.
Of rejection have taught me to just be paranoid and disbelieving.
But you actually showed this movie to an ape.
Yes, we showed this movie to the smartest, this is true, the smartest non-human animal in the world is this bonobo monkey at this ape initiative in Des Moines, Iowa, named Kanzi.
There's a picture of you and Kanzi.
That's me with who's who? That's me with Kanzi.
Yeah, you and Kanzi.
Yeah.
Now that you're just tempting Kanzi?
I was hungry, but in retrospect, it was bad to do that.
Yeah. Kanzi's like, that's why I love you. Yeah, that's my favorite food.
Like, that's mainly the only thing people know about me.
Yeah, exactly. But so you went and you met him.
Kanzi watched the movie. Kanzi built a little nest around where the TV is. Now,
this
Bonobo
is great. Does
Monkey,
Kanzi enjoy films?
Kanzi enjoys action movies. I think they said Kanzi enjoys movies along the line of Taken, you know, where there's...
Liam Neeson fan?
Stressful, but less violent than... like, as opposed to kind of a real John Wick, for example.
Oh, yeah, so like a kind of a thinking thriller.
A thinking thriller, yes, exactly.
Wow.
Yeah.
So Kanzi enjoys...
Kanzi's a reader.
He's a reader, yeah, of course.
But like, so Kanzi seemingly loved this movie, and then out of nowhere...
I think I have a photo of him enjoying the movie. He's him watching the movie.
That's right.
And there's your name up there.
Yes.
Kind of seems not impressed, to be honest.
Yeah. He's like, oh, the butterfly thing? Yeah.
He's like, oh, that's pretty. Yeah, the butterfly. Yeah. I did the butterfly.
We actually don't even like butterflies.
This is amazing.
Yeah, but
so how did he react?
Well, casually, about 2 seconds after this beautiful shot was taken, casually, Kanzi just slammed his fist into the screen in my face. It's like behind 3 inches of plexiglass because these bonobo monkeys are like 5 times as strong as we are. And so was really angry. You know, I like to think competitive.
Oh, yeah. He was competitive, but maybe he was taken by the realism.
maybe that. And I think he just really likes dominating any creature he can't figure out what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's fantastic that you did this. I think it's so different and cool, and I just love everything you do. But this
Thank
one
you.
Is definitely up there with one of the coolest
That's
things
so
you've
sweet.
Done.
Thank you.
I want to show a clip. Here's Jesse. Oh, do you want to set the clip up?
Yeah. I found a nest of eggs, and I'm trying to count to see if they're all for everybody in the group. And then the alpha comes by and kind of takes them away.
Okay, here's Jesse Eisenberg in Sasquatch Sunset. Take a look. Hey, buddy, come on. How do you do that? You're a great actor. That's amazing that you did that. Jesse Eisenberg, everybody. Sasquatch Sunset opens nationwide April 19th. Susie Essman joins us after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey.